Greetings, I'm Dr. Cynthia Rogers, Professor of Economics at the University of Oklahoma. In this video, I'll be discussing environmental economics. The environment includes all elements available in nature, including non-tangible things like solar and wind energy and air quality. Environmental economics focuses on how to allocate resources in a way that accounts for environmental factors. It builds environmental standards into economic markets to determine socially optimal allocations of scarce resources. Most of us are familiar with the basic operations of markets, where buyers and sellers come together to make voluntary exchanges. Households provide labor inputs and buy goods with their earnings. Firms provide products and services in exchange for payments. This is described using a circular flow diagram of the economy. The economic sphere does not operate independently of the environmental sphere. Energy and natural resources are inputs to production and factor markets. Some of these environmental resources are non-renewable and can only be used once. Others are renewable, but may be depleted if used faster than the rate at which they can be replenished. Production creates waste and pollution, which are added to the biosphere. Some of the waste are absorbed by the biosphere via natural recycling. Some is recycled by firms for reuse. When markets are well functioning, market outcomes will lead to an efficient allocation of resources. In equilibrium, firms will provide the quantity of products that consumers are willing to purchase. If you plot curves for the supply of and demand for a product on the same graph, then efficiency is where the supply and demand curves intersect. Markets are well functioning when certain conditions are met. There are lots of buyers and sellers. It is easy for firms to enter and exit the market. Information about prices and features of goods are known by firms and consumers, and there are no costs or benefits incurred by individuals who are outside the exchange. Most markets have imperfections, which result in inefficient outcomes. Environmental considerations are especially likely to cause market imperfections. We will discuss two of the primary situations where markets are flawed and consequently fail to achieve a socially optimal level of provision of environmental commodities. First, a common problem of markets in relation to environmental commodities involves imprecise cost-benefit analysis. For example, market transactions may involve a benefit or harm to agents not involved in the exchange. Benefits that accrue to agents outside the exchange are called positive externalities. For instance, planting a tree creates benefits to neighbors who are not involved in the tree planting decision. In this case, the social benefit of planting the tree is more than the private benefit of the tree planters. Since this benefit is not reflected in market conditions, inefficiently too few trees are planted. Similarly, using renewable energy will put less greenhouse gases into the atmosphere and thereby create a positive benefit externality, which is not accounted for in the decision to use renewable energy. Thus, we expect too little renewable energy will be generated and consumed. More typically, we think of negative externalities in relation to environmental commodities. When oil and gas is extracted from the ground, for instance, methane can be released into the atmosphere. As a greenhouse gas, methane contributes to global warming, but the effect of the harm on the planet is not reflected in the firm's production costs, nor the prices paid by consumers in the market. This cost is left out of the cost-benefit analysis. Because the actual costs are greater than that faced by economic agents, too much is provided, creating a negative externality. Externalities can be accounted for by imposing taxes on goods, which create harm to the environment. An example could be a carbon fee linked to the amount of carbon released into the atmosphere when a product is consumed. The price paid by the consumers would include the cost to produce a good plus a tax. If the tax is set equal to the external costs, then the market would reach the efficient level of production. A second important imperfection related to environmental factors is missing consumers or markets. Many features of the environment are open access goods. For instance, international ocean waters are not owned by an individual country or private individual. All are free to harvest its resources without paying for the benefits. Such free riding can occur because it is difficult to prevent harvesting given the vastness of the ocean. If harvests exceed the carrying capacity of the ocean's resources, then the resources will be overconsumed and can lead to complete depletion or extinction. This is called Tragedy of the Commons after Garrett Hardin's popular book. There's a coordination problem associated with common access goods. Individuals have an incentive to agree to restrain production to protect the resource from depletion. However, there's less incentive to follow through on production limitations in such agreements. If 99% of the fishermen stick to voluntary limits, then the 1% can sneak extra harvest and increase profit. However, all the harvesters would have a similar incentive to exceed the voluntary limit. Thus, over-harvesting is likely to occur, putting the resource at risk of being exhausted. This situation is called a prisoner's dilemma. Both externalities and open access goods are problems because property rights are not well established. Who owns the ocean? Who owns the atmosphere? At a regional level, it is possible to have a managed commons. For instance, Lake Thunderbird in Norman, Oklahoma provides surface water for 3 communities. The lake is managed by the Lake Thunderbird Central Oklahoma Master Conservancy District. The conservancy allows a maximum allotment to each community to protect the conservation pool. The global commons are more problematic given the difficulty in establishing international agreements. It is difficult for countries to reach agreements, and enforcement is problematic due to sovereignty of nations. In this video, we have learned that markets do not typically account for impacts on the environment or inputs from the environment. Notably, property rights are missing in the case of externalities and open access goods. Both can lead to overproduction of products that harm the environment, and open access goods can be over-harvested, leading to resource depletion. It is essential to understand the limitation of economic markets in addressing environmental problems.